Previously on Bantam Build.
One of the nights this week, I'm going to stay late and just kind of wrap some shit up and reorganize this place because it is a mess.
The fucking legs. I wonder who...
It's a little fucking goofy, but I got it up scrap, and honestly, it only took me a few minutes longer.
We're starting this short side right here. I just cut this side off.
Today, me and Joe are headed to the airport. We really think it's important that we fill the guys in on all the changes we plan to make in the next couple of weeks. You know, one of the things that I keep forgetting is we're not a small company anymore. And the same types of communication practices that we would have had 6 months ago just don't apply anymore. I tend to just do things and then people are like, well, wait a minute, what the hell's going on around here? So a lot of guys have been asking questions about all the different changes that we're making to the airport and that we plan to continue to improve the assembly line there. So we thought it was important to have a meeting today to go over all those changes and really explain to everybody exactly what our intentions are.
Gather around story. We're at a campfire. Story, everyone can share their ghost stories.
First of all, in spite of all the shit show chaos that this place has experienced in the last month, you can still crank out 7.5, I'll call it 8 units in 30 days. So, despite the, you know what I mean? Along with, you know, if Danny's got five, if Danny's got four other people in his crew, but he needs three extra guys, he knows who to come up and ask. And the other managers, those other faces of this assembly line know, like, that's to be expected. So what we don't want other key people from those different areas to get distracted and then... We all know how hard it is.
Okay, we have a lot of new guys that started, so things have been, power's been one of the main things that we've been having. We got so many guys here, all the power being run, we've been popping a lot of breakers. We're finding places for material when we have so many guys working, so many hoses run, so places for things and power, you know, that's the main thing.
How's it been training all the new people?
It's been pretty good. I like the new guys, and this is week two with all these new guys. It's been a challenge, but everyone's been catching on, and it's going pretty good. Things are moving along pretty quick.
Jeff's been working for the last couple of weeks, whenever he has time, to make custom shop furniture, specifically designed for the assembly line at the airport. One of the issues that we continuously have is the amount of sawdust that accumulates in just one day. As we hire more people, there's only more saws and more things being cut every day. And by the end of the day, it really looks like a beach. The amount of cleanup and sawdust that's just scattered all over the shop is too much for just one person to even think about cleaning up. So we've decided that all the furniture, anything that has a saw, needs a vacuum. The problem with the vacuums is, although it's a really nice attachment to have on your chop saw or your table saw, and it really picks up almost all of the dust, it's a real challenge to drag all this stuff all over the shop. So all the shop furniture that has a saw also is accommodating a vacuum. Vacuum is built into the cabinet. So when you hit the button, to turn on the table saw or turn on a chop saw, what ends up happening is the vacuum has a special switch in it and it automatically turns on the second that you hit the button or to pull the trigger on the saw. I really feel like this makes it so much simpler for everyone that's working. They don't have to remember to turn on the vacuum or turn it off or bring the vacuum with them when they move the saw. All they have to do is literally just hit the button like they're normally cutting anything, and the vacuum will automatically turn on. We're really hoping that this cuts down on the amount of debris and dust and also improves the air quality here at the airport. Well, after we demolished the office last week and ripped out that old nasty bathroom, and also we cleaned up so much stuff on that side of the shop, that we now have enough room to build a 200 square foot office. It's also gonna have a very strong ceiling so that we can store material above. Also, I decided to build a 6 foot high loft that spans the additional side of the shop to house all of the cabinetry and all of the fixtures and finishes to complete each of these tiny houses.